Today on Houston Life, from the food to the customs, we're learning all about Diwali, including the dazzling event in Stafford, where you can celebrate this popular festival of lights.
Plus, where you can catch a musical tribute featuring tunes from the Beatles and the Rolling Stones right here in Houston.
Then we'll meet the actors from the new animated Star Trek Prodigy series who are sharing their fun Houston connections.
And get ready to feel the burn, not in the workout, but in what you eat, how you can compete in Fat Eatery Hot and Spicy Luxa Challenge while supporting a great cause, all on that happening today on Houston Life.
Live from Studio B and KPRC 2, Houston Life starts now.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Houston Life on this Thursday, November 4th, 2021. I'm Derek Shore.
And I'm Courtney Savala. November 4th, it's a big day in our house.
It is. Someone has a big birthday today.
Connor, our sweet Connor, is the big 1-4.
How is he 14 already?
Yay! Happy birthday, Connor.
Happy birthday.
He was born at 8:25 on November 4th. And we just, like, I went down memory lane crying out my eyeballs today looking at all of his photos.
Look at that.
I know, my sweet Connor.
I mean, he was still just kind of a baby when I first met him. It's hard to believe.
It is so true.
14 years old.
I know. And, you know, he is such a sweet boy, and he's growing up to be such a young man. And I love this picture together of the two of them. I think that was his first day of kindergarten.
Wow.
Soccer. I mean, like, the list could go on and on and on and on, and it's just... it's unbelievable. And I was looking at a baby photo with him last night, and I was like, this is your last day of being 13. Does it seem like it, you know, it seems like it was yesterday that you were a baby. He has this photo of he and I in his room. And I said, that seems like yesterday. He goes, well, not for me. And I said, I know, not for you. But it does. I mean, you know, here and now he's, you know.
Remember when you were a kid and adults around you would say, wow, you blink and they grow up. And
yes.
It's like, why do all these older people keep talking about life going by so fast? And then you blink and you're an older person with kids who are growing up lightning speed.
I know, it is so crazy. So we're excited. So Oscar, AJ, and I woke up Connor this morning, and last year we played a different song. This year we did the Beatles song, You Say It's Your Birthday. He woke up a little bit happier than the 50 Cent one that we played last year. But it was fun, and he woke up real happy and had his birthday decorate, you know, his breakfast, got the 14 donut holes from Shipley, of course, and it was just a fun breakfast.
Happy birthday, Connor. I don't even remember 14. Very cool.
I know.
Holidays are coming up. It feels chilly outside. We both have our sweaters on. We had ABC Home and Commercial Services come out and do our holiday lights this morning, so they're going to be on tonight, and I've tried to convince Brandon to put up the tree tomorrow.
I think you should.
He thinks it's too early, but I think we're going to do it and just enjoy it.
I think you should. I'm okay with it. I think it's great. It gets everybody in the mood, especially with this chilly weather. Now, if you're planning your Thanksgiving dishes or your menu, I've got a plan for you. This is the best way. You're going to figure out your guests, get their birthdays, and get their zodiac sign. And this is the best way to kind of create your meal.
Oh, wait.
This is on Reader's Digest, y'all. Here's the question. Does the dish a person prepares or most loves say anything about them?
Oh.
And can the Thanksgiving zodiac sign pairings guide be basically your cooking plans and choices for this Thanksgiving?
Sounds very scientific.
Leo, I'm a Leo, and I would definitely want the deep fried turkey. And it says the trait there is attention grabbing. That's like the scene stealer when you bring out the deep fried turkey. Derek, you're an Aries, and your pairing would be the cranberry sauce because you're hot tempered.
No. Wrong.
I didn't agree with that at all. And I put in Connor's because he's Sagittarius, and his would be green bean casserole, which he does not like because he's outgoing.
Oh.
He's a little bit more shy. Out of the two boys, don't you think?
I'll trade him because I'll take the green bean casserole. I usually just take the cranberry sauce because I don't want to be rude, but I've never been a fan.
Never. Well, not the one in the can, the real, like the homemade cranberry sauce. You know, it makes that...
Yeah,
noise when you take it out of the
sound.
Can.
Well, there is a special. Do we have a special box on set? Actually, I guess we don't. I'm gonna. Maybe I can.
Oh, is that what you fell? What fell over backstage?
Oh, nothing fell over. Well, speaking of Thanksgiving,
I know. I figured this is.
So I got this special delivery here at the office. You know, Jones Soda.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan. Well, somehow they were able to send us this box of Jones Special Release Turkey and Gravy Soda. I know. You, the beloved viewer at home, you're probably salivating, licking your lips, watching the screen. Somehow, they were able to deliver this to us, Courtney.
Oh, it's nice and hot, too.
It's warm.
You're supposed to serve it warm?
Well, I mean, it's turkey and gravy. You don't want to eat it cold.
Did you heat it up?
So, well, we just somehow
warmed it. I hope it doesn't explode.
Does it remind you when you go to the doctor?
Oh, you're terrible.
I mean, typically, you don't hold a warm thing of liquid.
It smells like broth. Like chicken broth.
Oh, it actually doesn't smell terrible. I'm gonna take out some extra bottles. FYI, you can look it up online, but apparently they're sold out. What do you think?
It's like greasy chicken broth. Right? It's not terrible, but it's like grease. It tastes like greasy chicken broth with a little bit of bubbles.
Yeah, it's interesting.
Kind of effervescent. Listen, the grapes that are made to make this. Does anybody have a bun or something that I could just soak this up? You know, like some biscuits.
Some biscuits.
It's not terrible, but it's like bubbly bone broth.
So this is a limited edition. They only release 35,000 bottles. And if you'll notice, each bottle is numbered. This one's 08353. So I guess I got bottle 8,353. But they're sold out online. They're only like $2.50 each.
Listen, take this on a hike. If you get lost, I mean, you could pretend like you're eating a turkey dinner.
Actually, or you could just serve it to your family if you're hosting this year.
Here's your dinner. Cheers.
Zero calories, too.
No way. What's
Listen,
in it?
This is what we're having for Thanksgiving. Forget all the fixins. All right, well.
Oh, it's carbonated water. It's even better than a soda. Mm-hmm.
Very nice. Well,
very nice. Whoever warmed it up, thank you, because it really is that extra touch.
Mm-hmm. Nice and warm.
It's actually not bad. My stomach got a little crampy thinking about it, but it was not bad.
It's all going to be fine.
I feel
it's
like I just ate
fine.
A thing of gravy.
Okay, still to come on Houston Life, stop and smell the roses, or maybe the drywall, the weird smells that have a lot of people talking online.
But first, let's check in with Joe Sam, who's at Fat Eatery, heating things up for a great cause. Tell us all about it, Joe.
Oh yeah, Courtney, Derek, so we're in Katy Asia Town and we're gonna be talking all about the hot and spicy Luxa Challenge that they're gonna be doing here, all supporting such a great cause, the Ballard House. We're gonna be telling you about them when we return on Houston Life, and I can't wait to taste. It is absolutely delicious. We'll be right back with more Houston Life after a quick break.
Welcome back to Houston Life. So glad to have you with us today. So, weird smells. So many of you flooded our Facebook page with your comments, and there's a list of 18 smells on BuzzFeed.com.
Apparently,
18 that, I mean, we shouldn't say weird, but maybe people might find odd. Here are some of them on your screen. Drywall, chlorine, nail polish, gasoline, things that people actually enjoy smelling. We don't recommend smelling any of those things at home, except your significant other's hair. I think the others might hurt you with prolonged exposure. But one that came up for me was the smell of sawdust, because as a child, we did a lot of like woodworking in the garage or even at the local high school shop. Why are you laughing?
I'm sorry. Because I think of sawdust and I think of when I threw up in second grade. It smells like sawdust. So for me, it doesn't have the best memory.
Your elementary school had sawdust on standby?
It's like it was some kind of thing that they threw on throw up to like dry it up. It smelled like sawdust.
I don't think I've ever heard you wheeze like that.
So, like, sawdust really isn't.
So what happens today when you smell sawdust?
I think of me throwing up pink lemonade. I haven't had it since.
Okay, well, this conversation took a turn I did not expect. Why don't we bring in Lauren Kelly? Lauren, save us.
I don't know that I can. I thought you were going to say they like you threw up sawdust. I was like, why are you eating sawdust?
That's my strange habit or whatever that show
my
is.
My strange addiction. I eat trees.
I'm sweating now.
Oh my gosh, that is hilarious.
All right, well, we want to hear from you. What is a weird smell that you like? This question got a ton of responses on our Facebook page. So let's start with Darcy, who writes in.
Oh, yes.
My dog feet, they smell like Fritos.
Fritos.
I don't know about that.
Yes, mine too.
All right, Rose says, going to a lumber yard. Sawdust. My dad would always take me when he needed to buy lumber. When I smell it, it always reminds me of him. Rose,
sweet.
Now when you smell it, it's going to remind you of Courtney. And Kim writes in, the smell of someone getting acrylic nails put on. That is so strong.
So strong.
Oh, my goodness. All right, Denise says, the inside of very old trucks or cars. Have almost been kicked out of the car show because I opened a few old cars and trucks to smell the inside of them that were on the auction block. Ma'am, you got to get out of here. You got to stop sniffing the car.
Please stop sniffing the seats.
How am I going to know if I'm going to bid on it if I can't smell it?
I need a few more minutes, a couple more whiffs. All right, head over to the Houston Life Facebook page and join our conversation. We're going to share more of your comments a little bit later on. But you guys, okay, I have two.
Okay.
Play-Doh.
Oh.
The smell of Play-Doh and fresh cut grass.
Yeah, no. I'm out on the grass.
No.
But the Play-Doh, yes. Yeah. Remember the old school, like, Xerox?
Xerox, yes. Yeah.
The paper.
The carbon paper.
Carbon paper. That smell, like, brings me way back.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
They say that the smell is the strongest sense tied to memory.
Okay.
So when you smell something, it immediately takes you back. So, like, mowing the lawn reminds me of... You know,
of course.
High school when I did that at my mom's house. But I think that's a good one. I like the smell of fresh cut grass.
I will tell you, there are hundreds of comments on our Facebook page,
lots.
And they are very good.
They're pretty good.
Thanks. Not as good as yours, though, Courtney. Not as good as the sawdust.
Soaked in pink lemonade.
Yummo.
And stomach acid. All right. Thank you, Lauren.
Sure.
So on chilly days, what better way to warm up than with a hot and spicy bowl of laksa, which is a spicy noodle soup from Southeast Asia.
Fat Eatery is calling all spice lovers to put their skills to the test while helping support the Ballard House. Joe Sam is there now seeing how this competition is really heating up. Hey, Joe.
Hey, Courtney, Derek, yeah, the Ballard House, a really cool organization. We're going to talk to you about them in just a little bit. But take a look at this restaurant here at Fat Eatery. It really is cool. Like, the aesthetic of it, it feels like you walk back into time. And I just love all of the different billboards that's up here. It's going to be the same vibe that you're getting when you come here for the challenge that's going to be happening. I'm going to take a seat with my guy here, Alex, to talk all about it. He's the owner here at Fat Eatery. And the Ballard House, such a cool organization. We know that they are a local nonprofit that provides temporary housing to those who are going through any type of medical treatment or who are hospitalized. Talk a little bit more about why you decided to support them once again.
Since we opened Fat Eatery, Ballard House has been always our favorite charity organization.
Mm-hmm.
And for a lot of like the foodie group here, Katie for Ben Foodies, and we all support Ballard House a lot. We really believe in them.
Absolutely, and you are going to be supporting them once again with this amazing competition. Okay, so we have the laksa up here, and I tasted a little bit of the regular earlier, and that one was a little spicy too. So right now, this is the actual spicy laksa. Go through the rules really quickly of the competition.
Okay, you have one bowl. There's not another bowl you can like mix them up together. You have one bowl. You have 30 minutes to finish it with the broth and everything.
Everything's in here.
Yes. You see, the milk and the water is for you after you finish.
And you said they have to wait at least five minutes to do it after, right?
Yes, yes.
Now, if they win, they're going to be getting prizes. They're going to get gift cards here, and they're also going to get this really cool shirt. Let me turn the shirt around so I can show people what that says. Take a look at this here. What the F? It says, wow, tasty food. You're going to get a shirt, you're going to get a gift card, and you're going to be also getting something really cool that you can give back to the community as well. We're going to talk a little bit more about that. And, Alex, you know what we're going to do? We're going to be tasting this, Courtney and Derek, and we're going to put you to the challenge as well to tell you how spicy it really is. For right now, we're going to send things back to you guys in the studio as I get prepped up.
Okay, and there's not a level, right? Like, you don't work up to it. It's one major hot, spicy soup.
One and done. And you have to sign a waiver for it, too.
Oh.
We're going to tell you about that.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
We'll see you in a bit, Joe. Thanks. When we come back, why the fall season is the perfect time to update your home flooring.
Also, how you can score free tickets to a must-see tribute show featuring the Beatles and the Rolling Stones. Houston Life will be right back.
Welcome back. If it's a home transformation that you're after, fall is really the perfect time to take advantage of reinventing your space, and installing new flooring may be just what you need ahead of the busy holiday season. Maria Sotolongo, it's always great to see you.
Likewise.
Okay, so we are about to embark on kind of busy season, holiday season.
Yes.
But like so many of us, we're ready to kind of transform our homes. Let's talk about new flooring, because this really is a great time to do it.
It really is. We're just now before the holiday season, so maybe you are going to be entertaining, bringing family over. So this is the perfect time with a cooler weather. Open up the windows and let us come in and do the work, and you will have time to get your flooring done, maybe just in time for your parties.
I love that. Let's talk about the process, because I know a lot of times people say, new flooring, no way, I'm out, too confusing, much time. But you guys say this is very easy and convenient.
That's what we're all about, Courtney. Number one is we come to you. It doesn't get better than that. Most of the other stores, hey, you've got to go to them. You're kind of hesitant. You feel alone. You don't know what to pick. It's overwhelming. But 50 Floor is going to come to you to the comfort of your own home. We're going to bring you hundreds of samples so that you can then look at your own home in your own lighting with your own decor and then make the choice.
And what I think is great too is some of these samples are hardwood, some of them are laminate. I don't know the difference between all of them, but they all look wonderful.
Really, technology has come such a long way, even within these past 5 years, that it's hard to tell, is this laminate, is this engineered wood, is this vinyl, because all of these materials now can look like one another. So if you have a specific budget, if you have a specific style, let us come to you and show you what we have to offer, and you will be wowed.
And I think it's great, because normally if we're going to paint our house, we come home with a little tiny sample and try to pretend what it's going to look like. Kind of the same thing with flooring, right? But all of these samples come to us.
Exactly. So you're going to have it all right there, again, with your own paint, with your own cabinets, and then you can make that choice. What is your lifestyle like? What is your budget like? So our experts are there, again, to kind of walk you through every step of the way so that you don't have to do this alone.
And what I think is great too is you guys really know the background. So whether it's a high traffic room or maybe just a guest room, you'll be able to recommend what's going to work best in that space.
Right. If you've got dogs, maybe you shouldn't go with that hardwood. You know, if you've got three kids, maybe you do need something that's waterproof to prevent all the messes from, you know, creating even a bigger of a mess. So we're going to talk to you about all of that. Make sure you pick the right choice for you.
And also, it's convenient. You say this can be done in as little as one day?
Yes. Can you believe that? Usually we think it's going to take so long, but under one day, or usually in one day, of course, unless it's tile, that might take a little bit longer, but usually we can get all of this done in one day. We're going to come in, move everything away. You don't have to do any of the work, and then we're going to put down that new floor. So let us do all of that for you.
I love it. Outsourcing is the best. 50 Floor, all the options.
There you go.
50 Floor has a special offer for Houston Life viewers. Call within the next hour and save 60% off all materials. You can also use the promo code Houston Life to get an extra $100 off your order. Call 877-50-FLOOR. That's 877-503-5667, or simply visit 50floor.com. Now let's send things over to Derek, who has a blast from the past on this Throwback Thursday.
Yeah, turning now to classic rock, Courtney. How does this sound? The Beatles versus Stones, a musical showdown, is coming to Houston in less than 2 weeks, and five lucky KPRC2 insiders will each win a pair of tickets. We'll have more on that in just a little while. But first, from this musical tribute, we have Chris LeGrand, who's playing Mick Jagger. Welcome, Chris. You look the part. Let's talk about the show.
Part of it.
How did this show all begin, and what a great pairing?
Well, it's got a long history. Both bands were had their own separate touring entities, and then I hooked up with an agent friend of mine from California who was managing the Beatles show, and we just put this idea together. I'd had a similar show of my own that I'd been trying out. It wasn't really getting off the ground, and he kind of had the same. So we put our two heads together, and we wanted to put this package on a touring basis and take it around the country. And so we put it together, and you know, about 5 years into this, we've just been really successful with it.
Well, listen, you must have an incredible amount of energy because you're not just touring here in the U.S. This is actually a 125-city tour. It's the U.S., it's Australia, it's Canada. So you guys are going on and on. These musicians come from all over the world, right?
Well, the cast primarily right now is based in the USA. You know, with the COVID in the last couple of years, you know, we don't have any international guys in the show. So we're touring with the U.S.-based guys, and, you know, we've got a great cast of both bands and phenomenal musicians, authentic guitars, instruments. Everything about this show is very authentic. And so get these two bands together on stage, and it's just a lot of fun.
The tribute band industry really is kind of a big deal because for, I mean, obviously we can't go and see the real Beatles, right? But you guys have kept their memories alive in such a credible way, an incredible way. What do you think it is about these shows that have captured the hearts of so many?
Well, certainly the Stones are still out there doing their thing, but, you know, the Beatles were no longer toured after 66 and been disbanded since the 70s. So, you know, the chance to get both of them together on stage, which never happened in history, is just a phenomenal event. So we go through the different eras of the bands, a lot of costume changes, and then there's a grand finale at the end of the show where we get both bands out there together. And that's certainly a spectacle to see when you get, you know, Paul McCartney standing beside Mick Jagger and Keith Richards and John Lennon, and we perform a medley of songs at the end of the night. So it's just a fantastic show.
And it looks like you guys have a lot of fun doing it as well. Let's talk about some of the highlights over the years. In 2005, this production became the first ever Rolling Stones show to premiere on the Las Vegas Strip. This was part of the Legends in Concert show?
That's right. Yeah, we got a call from them to go out there and be a part of their cast. And so we went out there for about a year and we're on the Strip. And just a phenomenal experience to be able to go do that. And, you know, we started the show in 2001, so I had a five-year plan to get to Las Vegas, and we accomplished it in four. And so after that, our world really, really took off in our show. We got 21 years into this satisfaction, our side of it with the Stones. And so we've been very lucky. It's been a great show. We've done 125 to 150 shows a year for 20 years. So, yeah, it takes a lot of energy.
Yeah, I can imagine. I can imagine. You just mentioned you've been very lucky, but also your group is just absolutely so talented. We're tight on time. We do want to note, though, that almost 10 years ago, you guys did the world tour in honor of the Rolling Stones' 50th anniversary. Talk about perfect timing.
Well, that was perfect timing. And, you know, next year will be their 60th anniversary, so we'll certainly be out there for that as well. And yeah, we've had a lot of phenomenal things happen between us and the Stones. We've had a little bit of interaction with them and been a part of some special events. And so it's nice to be recognized, and certainly by those guys. And, you know, we'll just keep carrying the torch.
Well, I can imagine. They probably appreciate the fact that you're keeping their music in the forefront. I want to put the event details on the screen. Beatles versus Stones, a musical showdown happening Wednesday, November 17th, Cullen Performance Hall at 7 p.m. Tickets start at just $25. You can visit uhd.edu/CPH, or you can call 832-842-3131. Chris LeGrand as Mick Jagger, thanks so much for your time today.
Thanks, Houston. See you soon.
Sounds good. And if you would like to get your hands on free tickets for this musical tribute, all you have to do is, you guessed it, become a KPRC2 insider. You can enter once per day for your chance to win now through Tuesday, November 9th. And if you're not an insider yet, it is free, totally easy to sign up. Just visit clicktohouston.com/insider. Again, we'll have five lucky winners winning a pair of tickets each. Good luck. Now let's send things over to Lauren Kelly, who is living long and prospering this afternoon, Lauren.
That's right, Derek. Coming up, I'm having a fun chat with Brett Gray and Ella Purnell, two of the voice actors from the new animated Star Trek Prodigy series streaming on Paramount Plus. And we'll get a check of what's coming up for the news at 4, including a look at the change in the workforce and what it means for job perks. Houston Life is back in 2 minutes. Welcome back to Houston Life. Courtney and Derek back with you at 3:30 on this Friday Eve.
Yeah, Friday Eve. You can taste the weekend already. So we love today's question. Earlier we asked, what is a weird smell you like? Let's get to more of your comments now. Barbara writes in, cow manure reminds me of working cattle on the ranch with my dad. Seriously, great memories.
Oh, sweet. That's Barbara. Sweet. Love her. Jamie writes in, old limestone marble buildings in downtown. You can smell the history when you walk in. It's kind of like you said, that brings back a memory. It's like walking into a library, right?
Yeah, how interesting. All right. Mark writes in, sweaty leather like baseball gloves and saddle leather. Huh, very nostalgic for a lot of people.
And I will say, I think that was Jaime, now that I look at the name and the spelling. Sonia writes in, cheesy neck. What is that, you ask? You know, that milk that drips down into babies' necks, and because they're cute rolls, it just sits there in their body heat till you wipe it or wash it off. I miss my kids being babies. I get it, Sonia.
Oh.
I know, that is so sweet.
Cheesy neck, it just doesn't sound super appetizing.
Oh, it's a baby smell.
It's a baby
thing. It's like a puppy smell, you know?
It's sweet.
So good. All right, let's check in with Keith, Christine, and Frank for a look at what they're cooking up for four, guys.
Okay, you know what does it for me?
What?
What?
The smell of running diesel engines, like from Greyhound buses. I love that smell.
I don't know what it is. Well, actually, I think I know what it is. We should take a lot of Greyhound buses when I was like a little kid.
Yeah.
And
it
would to go see family.
Yeah,
so it brings back memories because we're getting on the bus to go visit family. I get to play with all my cousins and everything, but I love that smell. Oh my gosh.
You sniffed a lot of exhaust, didn't you?
Well, there's other effects from that too,
that
yes, as you
lot.
Are
no,
able to
no,
see.
For me, you know the smell of like grass and cement after it rains when it's hot out?
Sure, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I love that smell.
Yes.
So summer.
Yeah.
Yes. Summer,
so
spring,
summer.
Fresh.
Yeah.
I like coconut just because it says vacation.
I love coconut too.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
like that's Hawaiian a tropic, a little
yeah.
suntan oil.
True.
Coconut shampoo,
like
coconut.
Oh, yes.
I like to drink it. I like to put it on my skin.
Okay.
Love it.
Bring on the coconut.
I'm going to Expedia now.
There you go.
We kind of need to smell a coconut for today to kind of, I don't know, it's so gloomy out there today, Flame.
It is gloomy. It's one of those really raw days. You know, normally we get at least above, so we haven't been, had a temperature of the day where the temperature didn't get above 60 since February 20th.
Wow, okay.
Wow.
And that was the end of the big freeze.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It always gets above 60. It's not going to get above 60 today, 55 right now, 57 at Hobby, 58 at Sugarland. Galveston's trying, 59 degrees. It's going to be a cool, crisp one. By the way, up to our north, this is just out of our viewing area, north of Madison County. But this is a frost advisory until 9 o'clock tomorrow morning up toward the Tyler area, and they have freeze warnings that go right up toward the Tennessee Valley. The reason for this is because of that clear sky that you see. So they've cleared out nicely. It's still hanging pretty tough here. So the big question is, when are we to see the sunshine. I want to put this into a different mode so you can really see that clearing line there. But it's still to our north. Consequently, we're going to stay about where we are as far as temperatures are concerned because the cloud cover will lock things in the 50s. But look at this. We cleared nicely just in time for sunrise tomorrow. So we will see a lot of sunshine as we get into Friday and the weekend. But this evening, it remains on the cloudy side. Temperatures right there in the upper and the mid-50s, which actually is perfect jogging weather. So make the most of that. It's going to be a cloudy cold evening, and then the sky's clear for tomorrow, a crisp fall weekend. We'll talk all about it and how long that lasts for.
Okay, we will be ready for it, Frank. Thank you, sir.
Good. Yep.
Indeed, indeed. All right. A look now at some of the stories we're working on for our news at 4 o'clock. It's the first approved antiviral pill to help fight COVID, where it's been approved, and just how effective the manufacturers of the pill say it is, and when we could see the pill here in the United States.
Plus, you've heard about people quitting their jobs after the pandemic. Employers often having a hard time filling positions now as workers move to other industries or simply want to work from home. Consumer investors Investigator Amy Davis has a look at the competitive nature of the American job landscape and what companies are doing to beef up their perks.
And move over tiny homes. There's a new building trend taking over. 3D printed homes. A giant robotic printer pours concrete instead of plastic. Why advocates say this method is much better than traditional home building methods. Wow, interesting concept to say the least. Wow. Yeah.
You know, I was reading about that last night and it's happening here in Texas.
I just can't wrap my brains around it. You know, I just can't.
Let's build one.
All right, let's print one.
It's like a plastic gun. Don't they make plastic guns?
Oh, they do, yeah.
I can't even imagine what that must be, but.
Yeah, you can print anything. Just like you can print it out on a paper, you just do a 3D, right? All yeah. right, guys.
Simple. Sounds simple.
Simple. No problem.
Like how?
All right. We'll see you at 4 o'clock. Okay. Right. Well, the new animated series Star Trek Prodigy follows a group of young aliens who must figure out how to work together while navigating a greater galaxy.
Sounds simple enough, right?
Also simple. Yeah.
Streaming new episodes each Thursday on Paramount Plus. Lauren Kelly got a look at how it all came together. Hey, Lauren.
This was super fun, y'all. In this series, these young alien outcasts know nothing about the ship they have taken possession of, which Star Trek fans will notice is a first in the history of the Star Trek franchise. Actors Brett Gray and Ella Purnell chatted all about this new adventure series, as well as a fun few connections to Houston.
Fessa, you two are in cat boots. What's so funny?
Cat boots? You mean cahoots?
I refuse to be mocked by someone of your reputation.
And, what reputation is that?
How are you?
Good. I'm so excited to be talking to Houston. I love Houston.
I don't know if everybody got to, like, hear your excitement when your people, your handler people were like, you're going to Houston next. You're like, yeah, Houston!
I love Houston. Turkey leg hug.
Turkey leg hut, that's what I'm saying. So, all right, Brett, you have been here before. Ella, have you ever been to Houston?
I haven't. I've heard great things from everyone I know, yeah.
All right, this is your personal invite. Brett and I will take you first stop, Turkey leg hut, and then, you know, the rest will just...
Second stop, the Museum of Beyonce.
Oh, yeah, we'll just go on a straight up hunt for Beyonce.
Yes.
You guys know that I went to middle school with her. How cool is that?
Yeah, crazy.
All right, let's put all of our amazing Houstonness aside right now. We got to talk Star Trek Prodigy. This is a new animated series, the first of its kind of geared at a younger audience. Brett, why don't you start and kind of explain the show to our viewers?
Yeah, so Star Trek Prodigy is definitely aimed at younger audiences, but I say it's for anybody whose first time it is entering the Star Trek universe. You follow this group of teenagers as they sort of discover what the Star Trek universe is, what it means, and how they learn to sort of fit into a team themselves.
Ella, you are Gwyn. Let's talk a little bit about what your character is like. She's got big dreams of exploring the stars, and she's not really afraid to hold anything back. Like, is this a little bit kind of personal?
It kind of is and it isn't, I suppose. I mean, everyone can relate to those themes, I feel. But also, Gwyn is, she's a lot cooler than I am. She's just cool. She, like, fights and she's very serious and she, like, she's very together.
Ella, do they let Gwyn speak with your accent or do they make you take it away?
It's an American accent. But you know what's typical is Gwyn is the, she's the communications chick. There's a more technical term than that.
So you're a little bit cooler than her, I think.
Do you think so? Is it just because I'm British and so I automatically get cool points?
Well, you guys, what is it like filming an animated series? Are you all in the same room kind of voicing your parts or is it done separately? Is it a cool kind of way to do a show?
This was only my second voiceover job, so I didn't really know what to expect. We never met and we never recorded it together.
I can't wait till a day when they say Brett Gray and Ella Purnell will be recording in the same studio together this entire episode. I cannot wait for that to happen. We're going to have a blast.
Well, we might not ever get anything done, but we will have
nothing
fun.
Well, you guys are so fun to talk to. I know the show is just going to be awesome. Star Trek Prodigy, it streams Thursdays on Paramount Plus.
Thank you so much. It was so great to talk to you.
Such a fun crew to chat with, and it looks like they had a great time putting this show together. For more on my interview with the Star Trek Prodigy cast, log on to HoustonLife.tv. Now, Derek and Courtney, you didn't catch this at the beginning of the interview. Ella has never been to Texas, but she did dress up as a Texas cowgirl for Halloween by default.
Oh.
Who knew?
I love it. They are so sweet, very talented. I'm always fascinated with people that do voiceover work.
Absolutely.
And how challenging that is,
and
right?
Take away a British accent and speak with an American one. I think that's awesome.
And the fact that they never met during this process,
right.
They were all recording separately because
yep.
The finished product seems so cohesive.
Flawless, exactly.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Shout out to the turkey leg, huh?
Ooh, and Beyonce.
I know, that was awesome, Lauren. Thanks.
Thanks, guys.
Coming up, we're learning all about the rich history of the Festival of Lights known as Diwali. Find out about the dazzling local event where you can participate in that celebration.
Stay right there. Houston Life will be right back. Welcome back to Houston Live. Rashmi and Ankur Trivedi are just two of the thousands of people living in the greater Houston area who are celebrating Diwali today.
The couple, who are practicing Hindus and volunteers at the traditional temple in Stafford, are here with us now to explain the traditions around the Festival of Lights. Welcome to both of you.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
Okay, before we get into this unbelievable spread that you brought with you, let's talk about your family. I know you're a mom and dad,
yeah.
Two boys, 14 months apart?
Yes, 14 months apart.
So you have a lot of downtime.
To say the least.
Exactly.
Easy breezy.
Exactly. So they're 4 and 3. And I know that you guys are practicing Hindus and you're also volunteers at the temple there. Let's talk about that, the temple in Stafford, because
sure.
It is an unbelievable piece of architecture. Of course, it's where you worship. Talk to us about the details. For people that haven't been by it, surely you've driven by it. What is it, 33,000 pieces of limestone,
yes,
to build it?
Turkish limestone and Italian marble. And it's a beautiful structure. It's been there since 2004. And myself, my family, and other individuals, our friends, are all grateful that we have such a magnificent piece of architecture, but a place of Hindu worship where we can all get together and keep our traditions and values alive.
This photo on the screen is just unbelievable, and this is exactly what we're talking about right now.
Yes.
It is right here in Houston, right in our backyards. Let's talk about Diwali, because this is such a significant holiday, and the new year, it's really about looking forward to the next year with optimism and
yes.
positivity, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. So for us this year, it's extra special, right? Because my boys are 3 and 4, so they're starting to understand the whole concept of tradition. And, you know, my little one, he'll be like, Mommy, this is so beautiful, because he's taking it all in. But yes, Diwali for us is all about looking forward and positivity and just celebrating each other in our lives and having more unity amongst each other in the community.
And it's a multi-faith celebration amongst Hindus, Sikhs, and Jains all over the world. And it's a multi-day celebration. Like you mentioned, it's a celebration of victory, of good over evil, and the celebration of all the goodness in our lives.
Let's walk through some of the symbolic measures. Of course, there's lots of color and flowers and food
Tons
to go around this festival,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes, yes. So first I'll start off with, we have Mysore here. And we have everything. A lot of the sweets do have tons of butter, ghee, but that's what makes it delicious, right?
Right.
And then we have, so this.
I'm gonna try this
yeah,
one.
Yeah, go
I'm
ahead.
Gonna say, it looks like a Rice Krispie
so
treat.
So I was gonna say, imagine a Rice Krispie treat, buttery, with more saffron than you can imagine. And that's what gives it that beautiful yellow hue. And then we've
Delicious.
Got a ton of, if you need some spice, we've got chivdo here, and that's just various different fried goods put together, like an Indian trail mix.
Yes, that's what I call this
yeah,
one right here.
Yeah,
this
yeah,
is
yeah.
literally like a Rice Krispie treat slash praline.
It is.
Yeah,
that's what this
you
reminds
taste
me
the
of.
Nuts in it.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And then what do we have over here? What are these spherical items?
Yes, so those are bundi ladas and laddus, and it's once again saffron, tons of butter, and tons of flour in it, and you roll it into little unhealthy energy bites.
I love that.
Yeah, but
you know, there are so many different, I think, visually, like when we see the Madeira with the fireworks. So fireworks, like this is an all day long festival and
yes.
multi-day.
Yes.
That many of us can come. And now you're back open, right?
Yes, we are.
Absolutely.
We are.
And so some of the things we have going on actually this week and today and tomorrow are at 5 o'clock, actually all of the business owners are gonna get together and we're gonna offer a prayer for success in the coming year for their businesses. And then at 7 o'clock, we actually have the Aarti. And then at 7:45, we have a beautiful, spectacular light show that actually we'd like to invite everyone in the community to come and check out. It's a musical light show that all the family members and friends get together and the entire Mandir illuminates, and it's just a wonderful event.
And tomorrow is the sort of the big climax, because
yes.
it's technically the new year, right?
Mm-hmm.
New Year's
mm-hmm.
Day.
Mm-hmm. So tomorrow the program starts at 9. It's until 8 p.m. And imagine, this is like a microscopic version of what will be displayed at our Mandir tomorrow. And so at our Mandir, all the festivities will start at 9 a.m. up until 8 p.m.
And it's known as an ankur. It's actually a mountain of food that we're offering as our devotion to God and just celebrating all the great goodness that's going to come in the coming year.
Well, it is a beautiful holiday, a beautiful tradition. And for more information, you can visit our website, HoustonLife.tv, Rush Me and Ankur. Thank you so much for
Thank you
your
for
time.
Having
and
us.
And on behalf of the BAPS family, we'd like to invite everyone to come and check out the Mandir, the light show today at 7:45, and the festivities tomorrow as well.
We do appreciate you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Now we're going to check in with Joe Sam, who is getting fired up about a popular tasting challenge. Uh-oh. Hey, Joe.
Hey, Courtney, that's right. So I have the waiver right here, getting ready to sign it for their Luxa Challenge that's going to be happening here at Fat Eatery. We're going to be telling you all about it when we come back here on Houston Life. But for right now, I have to prepare myself for this fiery challenge. Welcome back here to Houston Life. You know, we've been getting ready for this Luxa Challenge here at Fat Eatery. I am so excited, but I'm also so very scared. We just finished signing the waiver. As you can see down here, Paul had to witness it for me. Our photographer, he wrote down here, RIP. No support at all that we're getting here. I'm here with Alex again, the owner at Fat Eatery, to talk about this challenge. I'm going to get ready to start tasting, but as I'm tasting, give people the information as far as when is the competition going to kick off again, and then you're going to explain to us what's actually in there to make it so spicy.
This Luxa Challenge is coming this Saturday at 11 a.m. and you can register on our website or email to us at spicy@fateatery.com. All the proceeds go to the Ballard House. 100% is for the good cause. Okay.
I'm ready. I have my milk, I have my water, and I have my bucket too, just in case. So I'm gonna start eating. You tell us exactly what kind of ingredients are in this so that people can start. I'm scared. Paul's telling me to like, come on, but I'm nervous. Okay, tell us what's in this.
It's a traditional Southeast Asian, Singapore, Malaysian dish, but it's not supposed to be that spicy. We have ghost pepper, Carolina Reaper, and Indian chili powder in it. And it's not for the faint of heart.
I can tell, and they have to eat the entire bowl.
Yes, in 30 minutes. And then you have to wait for 30 minutes before you touch the milk and the water.
I'm hearing a lot of sounds. Okay, Joe.
Here's our waiver.
We just signed our waivers, so they're out of the way.
Spicy.
He lost the challenge. He went for the milk.
So for each winner, we will donate another $100 to the Ballard House, plus they will get a $50 gift card and a T-shirt you saw earlier.
Now, I can deal with spicy, but this is really spicy. So we're going to go ahead and send things to Courtney and Derek. You guys have a waiver in the studio as well as two bowls of the Luxa.
So you have to try it.
So, Joe, while you take another sip of milk,
and please be sure you have water.
We want to remind our viewers, for everyone who can finish this bowl in under 30 minutes, $100 will be donated to Ballard House, which is such a great organization. It helps house families who have a family member undergoing medical treatment, essentially.
Go for it. I'm going to let you talk now because I almost felt like it might be worse when you stop eating. It definitely gets you on the first bite. If you're... hot,
it
spicy
definitely
person.
Starts to pick up the burn.
Yeah.
Oh.
What do you think, D?
I mean,
you're gonna go for it, aren't you?
With those,
I'll go for another one.
They're trying to get right now. They're trying to get right now in the studio.
Oh. Ooh. Wow, that ghost pepper is not hitting.
It's good. I don't know if I can eat the whole bowl. No, I know I can't. I can't
eat the whole bowl either.
Holy
so
cow.
You guys, good luck with that in the studio.
Good luck, Joe.
All right, Joe.
Good job, though.
All right.
Wow.
You keep going after the break. Hang on, because the noodles I thought maybe would... No. A look at what's coming up on tomorrow's show, including a hot fashion accessory you're going to want for the holiday season.
I've had two bites, and I'm already sweating on my face.
I can't feel my tongue.
As we head to break, let's check in with Kevin Frazier for a look at what's coming up on entertainment tonight, including the bromance between two Hollywood heartthrobs. Hey, Kevin.
Here's
Courtney and Derek tonight on E.T., our night out with The Rock and Ryan Reynolds. We're at the premiere of their new movie, Red Notice, which you never knew about their friendship. Plus, is Kim K and Pete Davidson's romance heating up? You don't want to miss it. That's tonight at 6:30 right here on KPRC2. Now, sit tight. Houston Life will be right back.
Tomorrow on Houston Life, famed New York City accessories designer Lily Sadugi is in Houston. Find out what's hot for the holiday season and what brings her back to Texas.
Plus, Katie, country artist Will Carter joins us in studio for a soulful live performance of his new single, How You Know. You know, I'm speaking quickly because I feel like the faster I talk, the less it burns.
Yeah.
I've now had 3 bites. My face is dripping with sweat.
You are dripping.
I don't think I can do that. If I ate that whole thing, I would puke.
You want the milk?
How about this? I'll hold off on the milk. Why don't we save this for Keith and Christine?
Oh, I love it. Let's bring it over. Keith, Christine?
Ugh. Yeah, I don't do spice or milk.
I do spice, but if, I mean, I kind of feel like I'm right there with Derek. If he's having a hard time, I have a
Derek,
hard time.
Wow.
My eyeballs are sweating, guys. That's how hot this is.
You're bringing me to tears, it looks like. Goodness gracious.
He's bringing the heat on this cold Thursday. All right, well, you guys enjoy that. We appreciate the gesture.
Thank you.